Hi guys, Neon Sapphire here in another episode of Pixelmon. Today's episode is called Got to Catch Them All, as it's time for us to make some pokeballs. Also, here's my almost complete Pokemon Center. Inside I have a healer behind the desk, and I'm going to make a PC now to go in the corner. So, check I've got the stuff I need. I need some aluminium plates. I need to go get my glowstone, which we mined from the nether yesterday. We need a redstone lamp. So we need redstone, glowstone. Don't think we need any iron today. I will need some sand. Okay, so I need a glass pane. So put that all in there for now, while we go and hammer our aluminium ore out. So today we need 6 of these, just like we needed the 4 for our healer. I will hammer these out and I will be back with you. Here we go guys, I'm on the last one. Number 6. Should make a better hammer at some point if I'm going to carry on making these. So 6, so let's make glowstone. I believe to make it into a redstone lamp. Okay. I need my glass panes, so the sand was melted earlier. I need to make into panes. Remember how to. There we go. And then I believe with any luck a PC. So let's go put this in our Pokemon Center. Just like in the game. So, when you open the PC, you can put your Pokemon in. Obviously I can't because I've only got the one. But you've got lots of boxes which you can fill with Pokemon. 8 by the looks of things. Now, we need to make some Pokeballs. So I've been out collecting a few more Acorns from the last episode. And different orders make different types of ball. So I can start by making a dust ball. I need 2 green and a black. That doesn't seem to do anything. Let's try cooking them first, maybe. furnace isn't on. Yes, we need to cook our acorns first. So for the two green and the black, that would be a dust ball I am making. And then I'm also going to make some friend balls. While we're doing this, I can make the bottoms of the pokeballs, which I need iron for. Let's make 10 of them to be on the safe side. And I did find one lid the other day. And then we need stone buttons as well to make the bit in the middle of the ball. I'm going to make the cobblestone back into stone. Is that in a furnace as well? There we go. There's one button. So we'll put them all back in the furnace. Hopefully I'm going to make 6 balls. We've got 3 cooked green acorns. Cook the black one, a red one, and a yellow one. Let's try this again. Green on the outside. There we go. And then make some more stones. Our discs on the bottom. Nope, we have to use the anvil first. So we needed 7, that'll do. Hopefully, this will be enough balls for us to catch us a secondary Pokémon. Fingers crossed. Like a traffic light. So, back outside to our anvil, where it is the night time, and raining just like it is in real life. How great is England? Here we go, it's looking more like a ball already. Go one dust ball lid. So I'm going to carry on hammering these out and I shall be back with you when they're hammered. Okay, so I've hammered out the balls and now we have to do the same for the bottoms of the pokeballs. My hammer's almost dead, so I had to make a new one. And it helps I use the hammer on the anvil rather than trying to break it. Try again. Hammer. It's a lot nicer in the game when you could just buy pokeballs. We've got 5 bases at the moment. Just do 2 more. We've got the right number for the amount of balls we've got. We can make our balls and go and try and catch us a Pokemon. Now the dust balls I'm making, they work better at night. We've got 3 friend balls, 3 dust balls, and 1 time ball. And the lights come up again. So I've got this muck. So we want to fight it and get its level down a bit, like in normal Pokemon. Hopefully he won't kill my Jolteon. And hopefully I don't accidentally kill it. Nope, he killed me. So... maybe we'll go catch a lower level Pokemon. Heal up Jolteon! I'm sorry, little friend. How about this Paris? He's looking almost dead anyway. Hey, Paris doesn't want to be fought. Get some fish while we're here. Oh, drown hen! What's going on over here? How about this nearly dead Geodude? Here we go. He's nearly dead. We will bag Pokeballs and use a friend ball. It's in its ball. Is it going to stay there? Waiting to see. We captured a Geodude! So now we have 2 Pokemon. Now I can switch between the two. So there's, well, let's go onto a flat bear land. So I've got my Jolteon, and we can also send out Geodude. Right. How about a Trapinch? So they look pretty cool. I'm not gonna hurt you, little Trapinch. Come back! Please don't run. I only want you as a pet. Yeah. Here we go. Let's fight it to get its level down. And I just killed it. Oops. Let's just see if we can catch it without... You can see the Pokeball there right by my feet, wobbling like it does in the normal game. And the third wobble. We've caught it, so now I've got a Trapinch. Yay, Trapinch! Yay! Maybe it'd be nice to have a water Pokemon. Could get a Magikarp. Level it up into a nice Gyarados. Use Trapinch instead of Jolteon so we don't kill it straight off. Okay. It's nearly dead. We'll use our friend ball. One. Two. Three. We captured a Magikarp. Yay! So, come back Trapinch, come back Jolteon. Let's go take them to our Pokemon Center and heal them up. I said last time that I'd check out about the potions, so when we're out killing Pokemon, and it seems that at the moment we can only get potions by getting them from drops from wild Pokemon. I did get a timer ball lid and a TM the other day from killing a Pokemon. It was level 30, so it seems the higher level Pokemon drop better stuff. So now we've got four Pokemon. I might leave it there for now, and I shall see you next episode. Hope you enjoyed watching. Bye.